Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. What another beautiful and awesome day today to always be in the presence of the Lord. Another day right now to give him all the thanks right now, to give him all the praise and to give him all the glory. Today is the day that the Lord has made, and every last one of us should always be glad and always rejoice in it. We serve an awesome God. We serve an amazing God. We serve a powerful God. We serve a God who is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. We serve a God who still sits on the throne, who still performs miracles and wonders each and every day. In the mighty name of Jesus, he is still in the healing business. He is still in the blessing business. God is good all the time, and all the time, God is good. And he is so worthy. Yes, yes, my brothers and sisters, he is so worthy to be praised. Every day is a day for every last one of us to always pour our heart out to Jesus. Why? Because every last one of us are in debt with him because what he did for every last one of us. Jesus don't owe you nothing, my sisters. Jesus don't owe you nothing, my brothers. When I mean every last one of us, every last one of us are in debt with him. So every day is a day to always lift him up with thanksgiving and praise. Every day is a day to always seek him and to worship him and put your faith in him, put your trust in him, put your hope in him. Regardless if you don't see anything happen, God is always working. He's never too late and he's always on time. That's why I'm always encouraging my brothers and sisters that praise is an everyday thing. It's not an on and off switch thing. It's not a seasonal thing. It is an everyday thing. Because the God we serve, the God we praise, he watches over every last one of us. And he has us in the palm of his hands. And he is working everything out to his perfect will. And if you are not welcoming the Lord into your home or into your life, or even your prayer closet room, and if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus, I want to encourage you today, please do so. Please return back to your first love. His arms are open wide. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. And he is so worthy. He is so worthy to be praised. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, we just come before you right now today in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me your thanks right now. Give me your praise right now. Give me your glory. We just thank you, Heavenly Father God, for everything that you've done and everything that you're doing. We thank you, Father God, how you're moving in our life. We thank you, Father God, how you order our steps. We thank you, Father God, for your guidance and your direction. We thank you, Father God, that we can always talk to you about everything, Father God, that you always make time for us, God. That, Father God, that you never make excuses, God, that you never too busy for your children. We just thank you, Father God, for your grace and your mercy. We thank you, Father God, for your love that you continue to give us each and every day. We thank you, Father God, for how patient you are with us, God. Oh, Heavenly Father God, we thank you for this word that we better receive right now today, this powerful message right now today, God, that's going to keep us full, that's going to keep us satisfied today. And there's no other place, Father God, that we're ready to be at right now today, Jesus, but right here in your house, right here in your sanctuary, Father God. Give me your thanks, give me your praise, give me your glory. We magnify your name right now today. We exalt your holy name right now today. Oh, Father God, we just love you, Father God, for everything that you've done and everything that you're doing. We thank you, Father God, for the blessing that we're going to receive this season, the breakthrough that we're going to receive this season. We thank you, Father God, for the miracle that we're going to receive in this season. We thank you, Father God, for how you're going to open up doors for us in this season. We thank you, Father God, for the rain that's going to rain down on harvest in this season. We just thank you, Father God, how you got put us at the right place at the right time in this season. We just thank you, Father God, what you're about to do for us in our win in this season. Glory be to God. Oh, Heavenly Father God, oh, Heavenly Father God, this is your time, this is your moment. That I know for a fact that you're about to show up, that I know for a fact that you're about to show out. Allow your love to move to this place. Allow your presence to move to this place. Allow your angels to join us in praise and worship, Father God, in this place right now today. I believe and I declare, I decree right now today in the mighty name of Jesus that someone's going to be healed today. Someone's going to be delivered today. Someone is ready to get their life over to you right now today, Jesus, and the angels are rejoicing in heaven right now, and you shall get all the thanks, all the praise, and all the glory. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father God, this is your house, the house that you built on solid ground, the house that you built on solid foundation, the house that cannot be moved, shaken, or bothered. Heavenly Father, Abba, Father, you are welcome right now. You're invited right now today to enter the house of the Lord, right here in your sanctuary, right here on your YouTube channel, right here on your platform, right here in my brother's home, right here in my brother's life, right here in my sister's home, right here in my sister's life. Heavenly Father God, I'm asking you right now today, Father God, for you to do a new thing in my brother and sister's life. I'm asking you right now today, Father God, to touch every last one of your sons and your daughters' hearts right now today, Father God. Speak life to it right now today, God. Open their eyes so they can see whatever that they need to see from you right now today. Open their ears so they can hear whatever that they need to hear from you right now today, Father God. Console them right now. Lift them up right now. Let them know that they ain't got to worry no more. Let them know, Father God, they ain't got to stress no more. Let them know, Father God, that you already took care of a small little problem that's been bothering. Let them know that they can rest in your words, that they can rest in your promises, God. And God, we give you the thanks for in advance right now. We give you the praise for it right now today. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, you're welcome right now. You're invited right now today to enter to the house of the Lord. Right here in your sanctuary, right here on your YouTube channel, right here on your platform, right here in my sister's home, right here in my sister's life, right here in my brother's home, right here in my brother's life. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to intercede and intervene right now. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to comfort us right now today because you are a comforter. I'm asking you right now today to control our thoughts, control our minds, so I hear your soft, still voice right now today. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to move through this place like you never moved before so we catch the Holy Ghost fire. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to do something like you never done before. As we repent of our sins today, Father God, please forgive us for our sin today. Known and unknown right now. Wash us through your blood right now. Clean us as white as snow. Heavenly Father God, I want to say thank you right now today for forgiveness for our sins. Thank you, Father God, for not remembering our sins anymore. Thank you, Father God, for the clean slate. Thank you, Father God, for the opportunity. Words cannot explain how thankful, how grateful, how honored and blessed I am to always pray, praise, and have fellowship with all my brothers, all my sisters today, and one body in Christ today. Heavenly Father God, I'm here today to let you know that I'm available for praise, I'm available for service, I'm available for the kingdom, but most of all, Jesus, that I'm available for you. Heavenly Father God, before I get started, there's something that's always in my mind about you. There's something that stays in my spirit about you. There's something that stays in the fruit of my tongue, the fruit of my lips about you. And now I just got to tell you how I really feel about you, Jesus. I just can't thank you enough, 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 Jesus. I just can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I glorify you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I magnify and I shout out your holy name the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I pour my heart out to you every day, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I'm in love with you the way I am, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. Glory, hallelujah. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. And if you're ready for God's word, let the church say amen. Amen, amen. The Lord said it's going to hurt them more than it actually hurted you. And the Lord said, he knows what you are going through right now. He knows the feeling. And right now, some of you might be upset right now. Some of you might even be scarred right now. Some of you even might be even torn right now or because of what somebody did to you. And the Lord said, it's okay. But the Lord said, they have not gotten away with it. So God said, they didn't even realize what they did to you. They got rid of a blessing that I gave them. God said, I gave them a helpmate. God said, I gave them a special friend. God said, I gave them a special spouse. God said, I gave them a special job. God said, I gave them a special assignment. And what they do, they dogged it out. They played with it. They cheated on it. They walked on it like it was a doormat. They just mistreated it, thinking they can get something better. They thought the grass was green on the other side. In their mind, they felt like, oh, God gave me this. Oh, I know God can give me something else. But they didn't realize you was a special type of blessing, that you was a special type of miracle, that you was a special type of help me, that you was a special type of friend, that you was a special type of job that God gave them. And God said, they don't realize it right now what they did. Right now, God said, let them sit there and jump and scream and think everything going good. A person will miss their water until their well has ran dry. And God said, their water is gone. The well is ran dry. And God said, when they realize what they lost, oh, help me through this thing, Jesus. God said, when they realize what they lost, God said, it's going to hurt them more than what it hurt you. God said, it's going to break them down to their socks. It's going to break them down to their kneecaps. And God said, when it happened to them, only they're going to say, I messed up. And right now, God said, they're realizing right now. God said, don't think everything is all peaches and cream with them. God said, said, don't think they all happy. God said, don't think that everything's going smooth in their life. Because God said, they're not going smooth in their life. They're not happy right now. They are miserable right now. And God said, they're thinking about you every second of the day because they realize they messed something up. They realize they put their foot in their mouth too soon or too quick. They realize it was something about you that was something good. And they knew it from the depth of their heart. But they didn't know what to do with it. They allowed their enemy to come in and to distract them. They allowed their enemy to come in and to bamboozle them. They allowed their enemy to come in and just put all kind of negative thoughts in their head. And they ran with it like they was running a marathon. But they didn't realize the marathon they was running, they was chasing their own tail and knowing they was going to fall, knowing they was going to trip, knowing they was going to stumble. But when they stumbled, they was not coming back up. Are you following what I'm saying right now? Because there's some people right now that they realize they had some good. And right now, I can tell you right now, they're in their feelings right now. They're upset with themselves right now. They are beating themselves up right now because they say, I had the perfect situation right there in my hand. And they fumble the bag. They fumble the prize. What I mean by fumble the bag, by fumble the prize, you was a rare type of person. It's a million of them, but it was only one of you. God designed you as a certified masterpiece, genuine, all day long. There was no stretch, there was no dents in you whatsoever. God knew exactly what he was doing when he created you. And God made sure that whoever had you was going to take care of you because you was fragile. But when I mean that you were fragile, I mean it's not like you was easy to be broke, but they didn't know what they were doing. They didn't know how to take care of something that it had some value in it. See, you have value in yourself. They had less value in themselves. You have more to give. They had less to give. And see, they don't realize what's going on right now. But God said when the lights go out, God said when that time comes, God said they're going to sit back, they're going to cry, they're going to cry, they're going to cry, and beg me to death to bring me back. But God said, I'm going to act like I don't know them. I'm going to act like I don't hear them because what they did, they smacked me in the face. But God said, my smack, oh, heaven, this thing, Jesus. God said, my smack is a little harder than what they smacked me. God said, my smack is a little harder than what they smacked you. So God said, it might have stung you. It might have hurt you a little bit, but God is going to hurt them even more when they realize what they did. My grandmother always said, give a person enough rope, they're going to end up hanging themselves. So God said, he just wants you to step back. He don't want you to intervene. He don't want you to intercede. He don't want you to go back and forth with these people. He just wants you to chill and just trust him. Because he's telling me to tell you right now today, when he realizes that it's gone, it's going to be too late. That means they go for anybody that walked out of your life. God said, don't you dare pick that phone up and call them. Don't you dare pick that phone up and send them an email or a text message. Don't you dare go send people to go look for them. God said they have the ability and the authority to walk out of your life. Let them walk. Because God said, they realize when you gone, when they realize what I'm going to do for you, it's going to hurt them more than it hurted you. And God said, what he's about to do in your life, he's about to show them what they gave up. God said, he's about to show them what was the possibility if they would have set their monkey butt down and just hung in there with you, they would have seen what God was going to do for all of y'all. But now God says, since they want to be disobedient and not listen, so now God said, they're going to see, they're going to realize what I have for them. And for somebody else right now, ask Moses. Moses had an assignment, and in that assignment, he had to lead the Israelites to the promised land. But Moses kept on being disobedient. Moses kept questioning Jesus. Jesus, time out, hold up, wait a minute. I got to put a stop to this. He said, Moses, I don't want to hear another word from you. I don't want to hear your crying. I don't want to hear your moaning. I don't want to hear nothing that you got to say. God has put his arms around Moses. He said, look to the north, look to the east, look to the west, and look to the south. He said, look at it right there. He said, don't you see that promised land? He said that you can see it, but you are not in it. It hurted Moses more than when he tried to hurt Jesus. And when Moses realized he was not able to go to the promised land, that he had allowed somebody to enter in, somebody who didn't work for, somebody who didn't pray for, Moses was sick, Moses was bitter, and Moses was lost. Same thing with Peter. When Jesus told Peter, he said, for the rooster crow, on the third time, you're going to deny me. When the rooster crowed the third time, when Peter realized what he did, what Peter do, he was hooping and hollering, he was crying. So as Moses went through it, and Peter went through it, and Judas went through it, what make you think the person that did to you ain't gonna go through it too? Once they realize what they lost and what they had, want you to listen to what I said, once they realize what they lost and what they had, it's gonna hurt them more than what it hurt at you. God said, you gotta worry about a thing. Because God said, I can do some things in your life. They're gonna realize they should have never done what they've done to you. They're gonna realize they should have kept their mouth quiet. They're gonna realize they should have been listening to everybody. They're gonna realize they didn't have options. They didn't have opportunities. They're gonna realize that their grass is not green on the other side. They're gonna realize they should never form that weapon on you, knowing good and well, hallelujah, it was never gonna prosper and it was never gonna work. God says sooner than later, they're gonna realize what they lost. Come on now, I don't know who I'm talking to today, but somebody about to realize it right now. Amen, amen. Let's turn our Bible to Matthew 27, and we're gonna read verses 1-5. That's Matthew 27, and we're going to read verses 1-5. And if you have your Bibles open, let the church say amen. Early in the morning, all the chief priests and the elders of the people came to the decision to put Jesus to death. They bound him, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate the governor. When Judas, who had betrayed him, saw that Jesus was condemned, he was seized with remorse. Do you see how bad it hurt Judas? It hurted Judas more than when he tried to hurt Jesus. See, the only time when a person do that, when a person try to hurt you, the way that they hurt you, when a person deceive you, the way that they deceive you, when a person lie to you, when a person use you, what end up happening, they allow Satan to enter into their body, they allow Satan to enter into their mind, they allow Satan to enter into their spirit, and they allow Satan to use them as a puppet. And they Satan tell them the outcome, Satan has told them, if you do this, this was going to happen. And they thought they were getting away. They thought they had a clean getaway, but Satan never told them the aftermath was going to happen. Satan never told them they was going to lose. Satan never told them they was going to break down and cry. Satan never told them he was going to sit back on the sideline and he was going to laugh at them. He never told them that part. He just used them as a dummy. He just used them as a puppet. Are you following what I'm saying right now? He was seized with remorse and returned the 30 silver coins to the chief priests and the elders. I have sinned, he said, for I betrayed innocent blood. What is that to us? They replied, that's your responsibility. So Judas threw the money into the temple and left. Then he went away and hanged himself because why? He couldn't handle what he dished out. He cannot handle what he dished out. Do you follow what I'm saying? A lot of people can sow the pain. They can sow being deceived. They can sow the lying. They can sow the cheating. They can sow being used. But they cannot handle the reaping part. That's the part we're getting. They can't handle the reaping part. They can't handle the aftermath. They can't handle what's going to come after what they did to you, because it's going to be an after. But in their mind, they think they have got away. In their mind, they think that they're doing something, but they don't realize what they had until it's gone. And when you realize that you had something good, when you realize you had something special, when you had something that was right there in the palm of your hand and it's gone, and somebody's going to share it, and somebody's going to reap the benefits of it, it's going to hurt them more than it hurted you. God said, watch what I'm going to do. I don't know who I'm talking to today. I don't know who this word for today, but God said, chill out my son, chill out my daughters. God said, watch me work. And God is about to work on your behalf right now today. And if you know the Lord is talking to you, and you know God is speaking to you right now today, say, Lord, I know you're speaking to me. I don't know how you're going to do it, but Lord, I'm going to chill out. I'm going to sit my tail right here and let you do what you do, because you can handle this situation way better than I can. Amen. Amen. And if you like what you heard today, and the word moved through today, go on and hit Jesus' like button. Go on and hit the subscribe button too as well. Can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into our life, to guide us, direct us, use us. I believe right now today in the mighty name of Jesus, by us praying that simple little prayer, that God is already working everything God in our life right now today. And if you ever want to get in contact with me or leave me a comment, my YouTube channel is withers.lt. Always keep Jesus first place, always seek him, always honor him. Always keep your eyes focused on Jesus, because he is the author and the perfecter of your faith. Continue to trust him even though you don't see things happening. Continue to hold on to his unchangeable hands and please do not let it go. Continue to pick up your crosses and follow Jesus. Choose faith over fear. Always continue to pray for your fellow brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter if you know them. It doesn't matter if you've ever seen their face. Prayer helps and prayer changes things. I'm always going to continue to keep y'all in prayer, my brothers and sisters. The only thing that I ask y'all God to do for me is continue to keep me in prayer and keep me lifted up to you. I'm serving ministry out to you. I love y'all. Stay blessed. In Jesus' glory, holy mighty name. Amen.